Hi, please help to revive the sweet chestnut production. It was a very, very big branch of production of nutrient dense food, and these trees are not harming the environment but benefiting it. They produce wood at the same time. There is enough flour for bees, and there is beauty, and these patches can be grazed at the same time. So it's about time to revive, because there is a new type of or new breed that doesn't have this fungal infection, and so this should be chosen, only this one, that this isn't repeated. And the other mistake that has been made is to have monoculture, and I would prefer to have sweet chestnut mixed with other trees. All right, let's look at this project in Switzerland.
I'm in Switzerland, above Lake Zug, and this is near Luzern. And I'm visiting a project on sweet chestnut that has a long tradition here and that is reviving now. So the project is here. It's an area of around 2.5 acres, and there have been old sweet chestnut trees, as you see here, and new ones were now planted recently. These new trees, they are around 10 years old, and the beauty of it is that there is a grazing of cows, of cattle in between. And now we go a little bit closer. Well, here we are nearby. So this is some old trees in the background, and here is new plantings. And as you see, cows are grazing here, and they are fertilizing the trees, because in order to have good yields, sweet chestnut likes to have a bit of organic fertilizer, and that's what the cows do. And I've also just seen one of the cows grazing the leaf of the sweet chestnut, so they seem to like that, and that's a very nice combination. Well, here we are near the tree, the big one, and here we have the fruit forming, and the fruit is now in end of August, beginning September. And it's a huge tree, full of fruit. And you see the trunk over there, it's visible. I guess this tree is around 150 years old. And on this side, you see something what is pretty typical with sweet chestnut, that the trees are, forming multiple trees. And that's something what is also working out, because they are having a lot of fruit as well. And this is the beauty of it. There are very, very, very old trees that are bearing fruit for hundreds and even into thousands of years, because they are sprouting again and again and again. And here we have a final look at this beautiful tree that is bearing masses of fruit. And the stunning thing is that you can produce as much fruit or as much food as a wheat field, but this is gluten-free, and this food is a lot better than wheat, but at the same time you get a very good quality wood, and at the same time the cows are grazing And it's a fantastic system. And I thank you for your interest.
Yeah, please spread the word and let others know. Plant sweet chestnut yourself. It's a bit complex, of course, but if you want to spread food trees, you can easily multiply the walnut trees. The squirrels are really seeding them everywhere, so just take seedlings where they can't develop and put them in a good place and take care of them for a few years. That's what I've done with very many trees already, and they are well developing. Thanks very much.